No, not at all.
I'm gonna be doing bowling twice a week. Once with my friends, once with my kids, if you're interested.
Okay, so turn the volume up on the guitar. That's the cotton.
Can we turn it down here in the bass down? Turn the low down.
Yeah, turn the bass down on that one. Check your vocals.
Check, check, 1, 2, 1. Take my my low down almost.
Okay.
Check, check, check. Check, check, check lower.
What?
Take the low down?
I did.
Oh yeah, it's all low? Yeah. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Check, check. Check, check, check. Gets me far. Check, 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 check. We good?
Yeah.
Okay.
So are you ready? Yeah.
You know what you're doing? You, like when you got your opening?
Welcome to this evening's Sage Talk. I'm your host, Kristen McKay. This evening, we got Mr. Elijah Moose with us. So,
hey.
How are you this evening, Moose?
I'm doing very good. I'm just really excited here. I want to share this thing there. Sorry, the link is on live, everybody. Yeah, I'm doing very good. Thank you for having me to your Sage Talk. There was a thing of me wanting to write down everything, a lot of questions that I haven't answered for people.
For sure.
There's no real rumors. I don't think there's anything really negative that would come out of everything I want to explain or have to say about it. So, obviously a lot's changed. Not many people are asking, and that's really good. I'm not throwing it out there, you know, I don't want it to be, a weakness. I love everybody. I need everybody to be powerful and be empowered. That's what keeps me going, is knowing people are going, you know?
Yeah.
So I'm jumping a little ahead of myself.
Okay, well, let's pump the brakes here. Okay. So where are you from originally?
I was born here. I was an assistant at birth. My status is 313, Nisishuasha Cree Nation. Mm-hmm. NCN, they call it.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah, everyone comes to NCN.
Well, so do you visit there often?
No, I haven't. You know what? From about 2001 to 2006, I'll say, I've actually made quite a few visits out there, the homeland South Indian there. So I made about equal visits to both places, you know, and that's the only time I went out there. It's very, very great being out there because, you're going out there as a stranger, but you're related to everybody, you know?
I know that.
Yeah. And And you talk to one person and this person knows you, and then see, suddenly you're somebody, and then I have to meet this. I love it. That's what I love about going out there. I haven't been out there though. I think the last time I was out there, I buried my Uncle Moose. So, yeah, and so that was the last time I've been up there. I spent a lot of time like in Thompson and Norway House in that same time too. So
So what age were you when you felt like really inspired by music?
Oh, okay.
How old were you when you started playing guitar?
You know what? I was actually older when I started playing guitar. Like, I knew I always wanted to when I was young, when I was 8 or 9, but it's, you pick it up and it looks impossible. You don't know what you're doing or what the things are. So,
yeah.
With guitar, it's funny, it came, my brother, he had a hit song. It was number one at the time. I think this was 2004, maybe, I'm not sure. Or 2005, but yeah, his song was number one. So before it was on the charts and everything, it was a 2-chord song, and they showed me how to play it. Darren Anderson showed me for these first couple of chords, and I kind of took off from there. But you know, I slacked it. Everybody knows your G A D chords. And
were you singing at that time?
No, see, that's the thing, like at first, I started a person, I could play awesome guitar, but I can't sing. I could never sing and play. That was my one thing. It took me about 3 years, I'll say, to actually be able to play the guitar and sing. But I was a champ at just playing songs that I tried singing. I wouldn't be able to do it. It was something like, I almost accepted it because I didn't care. Because guess what? I'm playing guitar here. That's something I didn't think I'd be able to do.
And you also do, you host karaoke and stuff too.
Yeah, so I'll tell you like about that. That was a good one with karaoke. It started off with, you know, with me and my brother. We got ourselves a show, and then, you know, as the area came on, we got a liking, you know, so we got other places, you know.
Nice.
And next thing you know, I was hosting in like 3 or 4 years of doing the same hosting.
And like, this is all over in Winnipeg. Right?
Yeah, you know.
Awesome.
I did like a lot of the, you know, the powwows. Like it's Singer's Paradise. I worked for since I was 18. And the thing about that, he owned that karaoke company, and he was actually my CFS worker before I turned 18 too.
Wow.
So I had this really cool close connection with this guy, and so that's why he hired me. He didn't really need my name or anything, you know, just write down your name, and sure enough, yeah, that's fucking, you know, I technically still work from when he calls me, you know. It's been a while.
And you do like sound and stuff as well too?
Yeah, me and my brother, Craig, Henny Soprano, or DJ Henny Soprano, what do you guys know, man? But yeah, he's the one who gave me the name Poor Broad. We've been working like non-stop together.
Mm-hmm.
Like it feels this year is the strongest. Like I'm actually 100%, like, I get my vibes from him, and we really, like, it's so weird, man, like, we feed off each other's vibes, and we can sniffle negativity, and we turn it into something else. It's so weird, it's hard to explain, like, as if we got sensitive or something, eh?
So you're just both building a lot of positivity.
Yeah, so, like, you know, with me and Craig, our DJing thing started before we were even 18.
And what's your company called?
It's called Primetime Empire.
Mm-hmm.
And that's been going, that name, Primetime Empire, has been going, I believe, since 2011.
Well, and you guys are open for bookings, open for hiring?
Yeah, you know, I'll type a description somewhere and we'll put it in there. Yeah, you know, it's pretty cool. But since, you know, since COVID, it has slowed down.
Oh, what kind of services do you guys offer?
Well, so we offer sound, I guess you could say, at a professional, you know, level.
Awesome.
I wouldn't say we're not certified professional, but just of years of experience.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I have been doing the audio engineering since a very young age, since I was about 16. So
awesome.
I'm very well into it.
You're very familiar to it, I guess.
Yeah, and so also DJ services, like me, DJ Poor Bro is one of my entertaining names. It used to be Moose the Cow, but I haven't really gone with that. So I had a rap career at one time, but we're not going to really get to that yet. Buy my book.
Well, how about you play them a song? And I know you probably had a couple in
your head. Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah, I did. I had a song here. I was going to sing. It's a Neil Young song.
Yeah,
okay. Right. It's I actually sang the song for like friends and stuff, you know.
Awesome.
It's a song about his hearse, eh?
That's pretty cool. So I'm really excited to hear your rendition of this tune. So
yeah. Yep. Looked up to you as a musician, you know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Yeah, like I follow a lot of our you know, our local musicians. Shout out to everyone, you know who you are. So for real, I can sit here and I can go on for names forever, right?
Sure.
Okay, let's play name that.
Yeah, it's like who played that one show that one time, and
yeah.
So do you miss the live music scene too? Like,
well, see, here's the thing with what's going on. Like, my confidence is up, and it's through the ceiling right now.
Awesome.
So what's happening is my main focus right now, and I'll get to that later for your show is. I have like so many projects that are going on right now. Everything from what's in progress is me and my brother Craig exercising every morning, you know.
Yeah. Awesome.
That's an everyday thing, and I'll get to what that program is all about. So
you've incorporated some very good health and wellness changes for yourself?
Just everything, like
how have you been feeling?
I can really easily say, you know, I'm not going to sit here and give you little war stories about, you know, how rough my life of addictions were, because, you know, I wouldn't lie to you.
For sure, and you are sober now.
Yes, absolutely. I have actually been alcohol free since December 21st, 2020.
Wow, that's
awesome.
That's quite an accomplishment. I'm really proud of you.
Oh, thank you. You know, like exactly, you know, I do see people still suffering, and you know, I can tell the difference between someone who wants and someone who doesn't, but it doesn't matter if they want or not want. I'm still always going to be there
for sure
to answer their questions, because you know what, it's not easy. I can sit here and tell you I did it, you can do it. No, it's not easy. Everybody would have their own way, and look at the, you know, the positive side. I'm sober and I'm willing to help. You know?
Awesome. Well, that's great to like give that support and also to create that awareness. Like, you know, everyone is going to struggle and they're going to heal differently. So that's a very important part about your.
Well, the hardest part is it's like it's also being strict to myself. Yes,
for sure.
You know. Yes, I am an alcoholic. Yes, I love to drink, but you know, I do accept the fact that I'm just going to have to get along with this stuff. It's never going to go anywhere. It's always going to be there. You know, I have best friends. I love people who are alcoholics or sufferers. I don't love them any less. So
exactly.
I don't drink, that would give me not the right to go visit them, because I don't drink. No,
well,
I want to.
They'll definitely get to their healing point when they're ready, and then, you know,
that's exactly
something where
that's,
we can bring
this. That's what I want to separate. Yeah, you know, I don't drink anymore. I can't hang out with you. So.
Well, there's definitely a lot of ways to, you know, to still continue having like a social life.
Absolutely.
And doing things, you know, that are very healing. And unfortunately, like, there is that element that does surround a lot of things, especially with music too, right? So.
Yeah, you see, like, lately I can listen to music, you know, it's weird, you know, and you're sitting there and you're happy, you listen to a song, and then suddenly you get the coolest idea, like you're gonna build a robot or something, you know. But see, no, so that's what music. I always knew I had it. It's funny, like, you know, 10 years ago I could write down over 100 songs. I know how to play and sing.
Awesome.
Today I can barely think of 10. So that's why I'm more of the go with the flow.
Yeah.
You know, so
just to kind of keep it just rolling as it
goes. Yeah, you know, because there's a lot of good songs, and sorry to say, a lot of them. Yeah, we drank, we had a good time. You know, but there, besides the alcohol and wealth, there will always be a good memory with that music that
we
play.
You can also create new ones too. So, like, what artists are you most inspired by?
You know what? It's like how it started for me in my music. It can hop like five genres, you know, if it wanted to. So it would just mostly start off. I never liked country. My mom was a big country fan. You know, my mama was the biggest country fan. And you know, I did my best. You know, I did some of her music. I liked Roy Orbison. You know?
He's pretty solid.
Yeah, well, when Kokomo came out, oh man, that was my jam. You know what I mean? So stuff like that. My mama got me music. And you know, like when Tina Turner came out with Love God Doing It, oh man, every woman had that album.
For sure, it was a really big inspiration
for
empowerment.
Yeah, so that's what you say, like, the beginnings of music, you know, like where my direction went towards it. I was never planning on being an entertainer the way I am. I've always thought myself, I was shy of a microphone. Even in elementary, I was so scared to talk on a microphone. Things just change, you know. I'm never without a microphone. Every people hire me to talk on a microphone because, you know,
you flow.
Yeah, not even that though. I just thought myself, because there's something Craig, he would have said it right there. So my genre has changed, you know. It is like Cypress Hill. You remember when Cypress Hill came out with Black Sunday? Oh, every kid had it. I didn't, you know. Snow, and you know, you're in denial too. You gotta fit in, even if the music sucks, even if you don't like it, you gotta fit in, you know. So I just think like music, memories, a song I didn't like, but it's still a hit, you know. I don't know where I'm going.
I just think you're just saying that, you know, you've had a different vibes with different like music through the years, and
yes,
it's like it gives you different feelings as you go changing through those years.
So
a big part of that is like putting that work into, you know, like what it is you're trying to accomplish, whether, you know, you just want to be in a good place, you know, you want to be happy, you want to, you know, like work on your aspirations or whatever it is that, you know, makes you very passionately happy. So I think that's where you're going with it. So
like the last 10 years it has been, you know.
Well, I'm really glad that, you know, you guys have continued like your work like within the community, because a lot of projects that do happen in and around Winnipeg, I do see like your music, your brand is always a part of like different you know, functions and a lot of.
Yeah, social media is like it's crazy, you know. Social media is the place to be.
Absolutely.
The place to go. So now I am a little excited. Are you gonna play me a song?
Yeah, I think I will. Yeah, so I'm definitely very thankful that you came down this evening. I'm really happy to, you know, sit and chit-chat with you about things. And, you know, I'm really, I'm very also, like, admire, like, just, like, your journey with everything you're doing. Like, you're putting a lot of work into yourself. I'm very proud of you.
Yes, I will explain a lot.
So I'll play an original. This one's called Sandy. I'm sure you guys have heard it before.
Years ago. Oh, nice.
Yeah, so I just I don't know, sometimes I haven't really been giving a lot to writing these days. I'm just sitting on like so much material right now. It's just kind of, I feel like I have a lot that I like to put out there before I start working on this new stuff, so.
Okay. You know, like, being on your show, you know, something like this that allows me with music, it gives me more forward. Like, you know, I didn't come with that much material, but the thing is, I do have originals, and guess what? I can not remember a single word, a single chord, you know? Like, it was from another journey, I guess.
For
I could say. Yeah.
Well,
so,
you can certainly recreate that.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
That music,
you know,
that's the thing. It's like, it just keeps evolving. Like, I know with, you know, like, different artists and, like, different instruments, like, as you go through, like, your musical journey, like, things change, and they definitely, like, inspire, like, different, you know, vibes, different sounds, so I would encourage you to maybe like get like a notebook and just start jotting stuff down.
You're right about that. Like with things, you know, with things that are changing, you know,
for sure.
With today's music and with, you know, say words that are offensive or ways that are offensive, you know, like having an old rap song from 2006 or something, you know, or having a song that had, you know, a bad word in it or something, you know. But,
well, I've been hearing some stuff on the radio these days. It doesn't seem like
it's
so unnatural, but
yeah,
it's kind of weird hearing
it's,
it. But I, you know, anything I do want on the radio, like I'll gladly change it, like, because I want my music played.
It,
but there's some songs I do have, like, some not so great words in, I guess, but, you know.
How it is for. What were you saying about the music?
Well, just, you know, having like your original stuff.
No, okay, sorry, yeah. So the thing is, what I do, like with the songs that I had before,
mm-hmm.
I almost wish I could change them. I would never though, because you know what? It puts me at that part of what I was thinking at the time. My new thing is what I've been doing on my journey is I extract almost as much negative as I possibly can. So meaning writing a new song today, it would I'd probably make it a, you know, a genius song, like having, you know, I guess OCD will call it, you know, and being a perfectionism, you
for
know,
sure.
I don't stop. Sometimes a song can take me like 4 or 5 nights when anybody said you could have just wrote that overnight, you know what?
Yeah.
You can't. It's
are
art.
You still writing music right now?
You know what? I'm not. So that's like I said, being on your show, something to shoot for. Maybe I can come back and, you know, a few
sure.
word episodes, and I can show you something
absolutely.
Really positive and vital, because it's not everything that is going on, like you know, not using substances.
Do you feel like you have a more like reflection about your ideas and stuff?
Oh, so here it is, like with what I was using, you know, it was a lot of wasted time, I would say. Okay. But to me it was the greatest time, you know, at the time, of course, you know, you'd rather do that, be with your friends.
For sure.
But now I notice like how precious time is. Like how much I want to do with my family now, how much there's so much I want to be, there's so much apologizing, there's so much rekindling.
Absolutely.
And this and everybody who was with me on this journey, there's so many are actually standing by me without giving me a hard time, and so much support
for sure.
that comes in. You
well,
know?
I know, like it gets into that habit too, like when we find something that kind of frees us from that pain that we carry, right? We're gonna actually, you know, we're gonna turn to that more than anything, right?
Yeah,
So at the same time too, like with, you know, your healing and stuff like that, that's great to hear you have a lot of people support you, because that's certainly what you need in the end. Right?
Yeah.
You know, you can't do it by yourself, but when you have amazing people in your life and they give you that that push, that lift, you know, that support, it's like you really feel a lot better about
it. It's
so.
Absolutely that. Even what comes with it, though, I still have that mentality, you know, but it's useless to me now, though. It's a useless skill I have now, you know, the mentality of, say, making myself look busy for your day. Okay.
Yeah, for sure. Like
so,
it seems like you're putting a lot of your
yeah,
production
yeah,
into
my,
things that are important.
So,
to
so,
you,
so like with my walks, like I'll use this as an example. Okay,
yeah.
When I take my morning walk, my brother Craig. Every morning we've been doing this. We've actually been doing this walk longer than we boast and advertise. We've been doing it about 7 years.
Really?
Not really every morning, but sometimes we get on a stride, sometimes we don't.
So what's like the main focus with you guys
do? So this year, so the walk is wasn't really about our exercise. We figure what we eat is what we eat and how we treat our bodies. So our exercise is both of us. We hang on to each other, okay? Like meaning I'm gonna give you this example, okay? A child goes into a room one day, okay? You put him in that room to go play and make a mess, okay? In that room. So your brain of the day would be that child in that room making a mess, okay?
Yeah.
And then you go to sleep, nobody cleans that mess, you know? You wake up, that mess is still there. So the purpose, before you start your day, like really before you eat your coffee, we go for a walk, we get together, you know, even if we're grouchy, whatever, we're just warning people. Yeah. I wake up, my problem's like, hey bro, my heart's beating a little fast, or I could be having an anxiety attack. No, we go for a coffee, we go for a walk, it's to clean that mess that was made, so I can go on with my day and just
start fresh.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
It's working, because every day I talk to myself now, like sometimes when things I used to get eager about, you know, hey, can you pass my phone? What? You know, and that would make me mad before. You know, and I learned not to get mad anymore. I do everything to cast like negativity as much as I can without being ignorant. And there's a lot of people.
So you're just learning a self-control and self-balance.
Yes, without being selfish and at the same time moving my way in there. Because also remember, I do have some of the friends and family that I only drink with. So, you know, or I've only had a party with. And we've done nothing else, so I want to change all that
for
the better, you know, like using smudge. I didn't use smudge really until you recommended it, you know.
Well, it's definitely a really good process. It kind of helps you like center yourself, you know, especially because like it's our traditional medicine, right? It's, you know, very calming and soothing.
It has energy. I love it.
Well, it helps also just kind of slow us down a little bit, you know. Just it gives us that. That moment to just, you know, say your prayers, you know, and give that a good energy to the universe.
Yeah.
So I'm really glad that you did.
Well, see before a walk, sometimes we'll say, well, it's weird, we both smudge at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but when we go for a walk, the one thing that, you know, like I'm off benzos. That's a big thing that everybody, you know, is suffering with. It's one of the worst to be addicted to, but you know, I used it excusably, like, oh, I only use it to sleep. I would get rid of them, you know. But I'd always have every third or fourth day, I'd always have that. And then I went cold turkey. Guess what?
So what have you been using, like, for your treatments and stuff like that?
Okay, like, for my anxiety, okay? Mm-hmm. I'm going to tell you the whole story right now of how this one went, okay? So in October, I started CBD oil. I've done it before in the past. Yeah. I've done it, you know. I've given it a chance about 3 or 4 times prior. It never worked for me. So I took chance on this guy. He said, I got real CBD oil. I grabbed it. I tried it. So at the same time that I had the CBD oil, I contracted COVID. Okay? So this was in October. So about the weekend, the weekend is when we had COVID. I started CBD, so that Monday, say.
Yeah.
So the CBD must have taken full effect because I didn't feel sick. You know, I knew I was sick. My body was sick, but no. I think the CBD started. I didn't know what it is. CBD is for everybody, and everybody can take it into their own of how it is, because it's how it got me off painkillers. It took away my cravings for alcohol, you know. And now when I wanted to go off those benzos for my anxiety, you know, I kind of didn't really, my doctor says use THC. So I'm using it as a medicine now. And you know what? At first I was scared of it. I was scared of THC. You know, I had a fear of it. I didn't like, I always felt uncomfortable when, you know, when I smoked the THC.
Yeah.
But now that I use it as medicine, it's, I don't like to compare it like it, but it is like, it acts like one of those benzos that I have. It helps me sleep.
So,
you know, like if you use it like a medicine and not a party, it focuses you.
And
you know,
also made a lot of changes in your diet as well, right?
It's really calm, because that's one thing that I'm still struggling daily to conquer with is my depression, anxiety.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, I can go to people's houses and just start crying for nothing, or you know, or not. I could be quiet and kind of seeing and hearing, you you know, and it's weird because it's just like something attacking me, you know, and that's what I use a walk for, just to avoid all that buildup there, so I don't get, you know, go into a freeze state because I'm so freaked out. And
well, it's good too to release like your emotions too. Like I learned recently that it basically means like the grandmothers are near, so. You know, never feel like you can't let your emotions out. You know, don't feel like you can't express that, because you'll feel a lot better once you kind of let, you know, some stuff out. It's like, that's a big thing too about like our traumas we have, you know, like they're, some of them are not ours to carry. So we definitely have to just keep, you know, healing in our own ways and at our own paces too, because like it's not always going to be the same. And you know, there's no right time where someone's like, oh yeah, like I'm going to be 40. I'm supposed to heal now. No, like, unfortunately, like sometimes it doesn't happen that way, but sometimes it does. And
yes,
it's a great thing.
The hard part about it though, is you know what, I haven't had an anxiety attack until I got off the meds. Okay?
For sure.
My first anxiety attack came, guess what? For 20 years, I never had anxiety attack. For 20 years, I had the answers to everybody who had anxiety attack to calm them down.
Sure.
I knew what anxiety attack was. I knew how to calm them down. I knew what to do. And everybody thanked me and my method worked for everyone. Guess what happened? I had an anxiety attack that I couldn't calm down. I didn't know what to do, you know? And I was telling myself, it's not anxiety attack. So that's heaviness. There's the tricky part of my brain playing tricks on me just to, you know? And I gotta watch for things like that, things of me being more than kind. A hard thing for me working on myself is I'm starting to pick up my phone more.
For sure.
My phone can ring about 50 times a day. I won't answer a single call. It'll just ring, you know. I'm starting to answer my call now. It's not that it's rude. It's just for some reason I can't talk on the phone. I want to, small changes like that, you know, something, anything that can cause an impact of positivity.
Wow, well, that's awesome.
Yes.
Do you feel like singing another song for us?
You know what? I would love to.
Alright. So you pretty much lived in Winnipeg your whole life then, I guess?
Yes. Shout out to my mama, Gloria Novus. Yeah, I was raised very good. You know, people say it's Craig, my real brother. He's actually not, like, we're not related, you know, biologically.
Like a found family.
Yeah. Oh no, he's my brother. He's like, you know, he's a man. He's fucking.
Yeah, he's pretty awesome. Like, I've definitely taken a big notice about his support to you. So big shout out to your bro there. I think our next one, he'll definitely join us.
This one's going real big. I can't do it from the beginning, but we'll try it out.
Say those things you want to hear.
Yeah.
No, no, eh? Ever insulting telling you that, eh?
It reminds me of Stars on 45. I've always had such a big liking for that that mix, and I don't know. I don't think I've ever
seen. Have you done a full karaoke one yet?
Of the Stars on 45.
Yeah. I've seen one lady do two of them complete, and she nails it. But that's a tough one, I know.
There's one of just of their songs, and then there's another one of like all the kind of the 50s type, similar, you know, like the Archies. Yeah.
Yeah.
I haven't tried it, but that was a really good.
So that's what it reminded you of?
Yeah.
I don't know. It scared me. Like, hey, you know, 100 songs, pick another one though. So. When I came in, actually, you know what? I had a cover that I did want to do. I had no time to get to it, man. JC, shout out to you. Like, I do. I owe you a song. You know what? I'll come back on here. Like, guest moment. You know what I mean? Oh, look who's in the house. Just interrupt someone when they're doing their show.
Well, I definitely like to have you back again too. Like, I know that my you know, the setup I have right now might you know, change eventually, and I'm pretty sure it's gonna.
Oh, so. Yes.
Definitely have a couple of people over, and you know, I have some really amazing guests coming up actually, so I'm really excited. You'll have to definitely stay tuned for those next upcoming shows. And again, if you do want to come and, you know, hang out and do some sage talk, you know, come sing some songs,
and you know what,
tell some stories, you know, definitely shoot me a message. I'd love to have you.
And promote. Remember, you promote your work.
Absolutely.
Yeah, yeah.
I just like give a big shout out to Live Edge Entertainment. Okay. Yesterday was pretty badass.
Can you picture me coming at you? Yo, check it out. What's up? It's your boy, Pro Bro. You know what I'm saying? Yo, check this out. We're going to drop some YouTubes and all that, man. What's up?
Awesome. So, are you getting excited for summer, or how are you feeling about that?
You know what? It's a big summer change. I need to get my shoulder fixed.
How's your new bike you got?
It got a flat. The rate when I bought a new tire for it, the tread, we were proud. I was just driving, you know. I think it's just too much air. I think my brother puts too much air in it, but we won't talk about that right now. For real, it's biking is amazing, man. I didn't think I could do it.
What kind of trails do you hit up with?
I can't do trails right now. Like, I can't even stand in that because my shoulder pops out and I wipe out. I'm beyond messed. You know what I mean? So I'm not going to risk it like that. But cycling, oh, it gets my anger out. It's weird. Like, now I know why when people work out and they listen to heavy metal, because you get that feeling, you know. I like that feeling of being high, but it's a little, can be dangerous to me, because when, you know, when you're on that super high of happy, mm-hmm. you don't eat, you don't drink, you know what I mean? You forget to eat.
Well, I understand that, but like for sure, like in that, you know, in the busy moments of our lives, yeah, it's good to just have something, you know, just something small. Like I say that, but I don't listen to myself, because like I'm like that too. Or,
don't feel bad.
Yeah.
All right.
I don't know. I'll probably sing another one for you.
Okay.
And
okay.
Like I told Elijah earlier that, you know, I never really know what I'm going to play. I, you know, just.
Sing my name again. You say Elijah, right?
Elijah. Elijah. Yeah, so that's awesome. So thank you guys so much for joining us with Sage Talk. I'm really, really happy about just the energy, the vibes. You know, it's something to definitely look forward to. I feel really happy to be doing this. So anyone that's tuned in and checking us out, thank you so much. Again, like I said, if you want to come on Sage Talk, you gotta hit me up. So really like to have you guys down.
Yes, indeed.
I guess since you played some Neil Young, maybe I'll play some too. Just.
Yes. When they say it's amazing, it's actually like the best music
around the planet. Yes, I do agree to that. Yeah, Neil Young is like, oh my god, he's just like super inspiring. Like, I just it took me a very long time to actually learn that song, and so I'm still learning. And you know, it's a good vibe. I think his music is very healing.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. So I'll think of a good song here for you guys.
Awesome. Well, again, I just want to thank you guys so much for joining us this evening. It's just it's been a lot of good vibes with Moose, and really happy it came down. So.
Oh, thanks for having me, for real.
Absolutely.
No country song I like playing here. No Jimmy Buffett song. Maybe I'm a sponge cake, watching the sun bake. All those tourists covered over. Drumming a thick string on my throat coat's thin. Several shrimp and a energy boil. Whisper at a lady, keep me in moderator bill. Searching for my life, I shed through a song. Nobody's home. Don't know the reason. I blew up my flip-flop. Cut my heel and the cruiser back home. Oh, it's a real cutie. A Mexican cutie. How in the hell I have any clue? Whisked it away again in Margaritaville. Whisked for my home, my shit for a song. Some people play me as a whole world to play. It could be my fault.
Check. season. As here I was season. Nothing sure but this brand new tattoo. Up in the blender. And soon we'll be under. That frozen concoction of heroes we hang on. Twisted away again, a margarita bill. Drinking on my own, I shake your song. Some people blame the devil, oh, motherland, but I think it's my own dear fault. But I think it is my fault.
Yeah, one of those only thing could bring that song up anywhere, any crowd, even kids know that song.
There was like a couple pops though with that one. There. I was just like actually watching you play.
Hell yeah, you're just snapping at me like.
And then your mouth touched the mic and it just, I don't know.
Oh, static game.
Yeah, a little bit. So, I don't know. I think, you know, sometimes you definitely got to work with what you got. So, got some of the sound a little bit, you know, better, but. Definitely, yeah. That was a great tune. Like, I'm very, I'll use this one, very empowering. Like, I was really surprised in your vocals with that one. Do you do that with karaoke, that one?
It's kind of one of those breakout songs. For real, I keep, that's what I said, that's a song, like, anywhere you go. You know?
I really appreciated it. That was an awesome one, actually.
I was at the Ashton Stompers one time. Like, oh, we're going to call Moose. I'll be like, what the heck, man? Call Moose. I didn't know what to say, so like, you know, said, let's do some margarita bill, I guess.
Yeah.
What you got for me?
Well, I, like I said, I really never really know what I'm going to play, but, you miss going to concerts?
No.
No? Oh my god.
My last one I went to, I didn't stay. I did Def Leppard on my birthday about 4 years ago, 5 years ago, I'd say.
Well, I would have loved that one too.
There's other reasons we didn't go to.
I'm not hating on that one. It's just, you know, that's not really, I don't know. I guess I appreciate some of their tunes. I know they got so many, like, you know, like their greatest hits. Like, they could probably have two of those albums.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
I'm not even too sure, but I guess, I don't know, maybe I'll just finish her off with a little. Something, you know, it's a long weekend and all, so finish her off a little.
You know what? This is going to be very successful. I'm going to be shooting like he's left and ready, making it to stop it there. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I was really looking forward to the next couple episodes. So thank you guys so much for joining us. We'll just I'll probably sing another song and then we'll have a close with Elijah. And thank you guys for tuning in to Sage Talk tonight. I really appreciate that. Put a candle in the window. Don't have to worry no more.
Tracks always get you lit up, right?
Well, it's a nice closer too, because it kind of, you know, a little bit softer, you know, kind of gives a different kind of
vibe. That's so very good. Thank you for having me, like, totally 100%. And you know what? Like, there's tons of ideas. You know what? I know it's only an hour or whatever we can. There is a lot, and I'm going to be properly more written down for, like, next time. I really want to do this, because this is such a brilliant idea you have.
For sure. Well, like, I just kind of felt like it was important to have, like, a, you know, a platform to share somewhere, you know, where we can sit and, you know, just relax, you know, play some music, you know, have some good vibes.
Exactly.
And I mean, it doesn't always have to be like you know, musical based. You can definitely have different discussions, you know, especially about things that, you know, people are unfamiliar about, they're not sure. So, like, even if you have any ideas about, like, Sage Talk, you know, we're going to be doing one about hypo and hyperactive thyroidism. So that one's going to be coming up. I'm actually, like, really excited to do that one, because it touches on a lot of, like, stuff with, like, you know, your mental and emotional state. So it's like a kind of going to be like a, you know, a learning information type thing, but also just to share those stories, because, like, this struggle is, like, it's real. Like, you know, there's anxiety, depression, but, you know, if you mix a thyroid problem in with that, like, man, it's not easy, you know?
Yeah, and like, depression, anxiety is as real as it already gets. Nobody else wants to deal with something.
Exactly. Well, yeah. I'm very honored to have you, like, so, like, you know, especially with everything you're going through. Like, you know, I've known you for a long time.
Yeah.
I've actually never been this, you know.
No, we've
to
never
you,
been tight. We can go back, like 12, maybe 13
and
years, you know. And you know what, though?
Yeah.
I've always looked up to you, though. I really did. Like, mm-hmm. you know, when I saw you doing things and seeing your promotion doing gym, I was like, you know what, this girl's working. And guess what? You know what? It would be an honor to know where I always thought that. So, leaving the honor is mine.
Oh man, that makes me feel so awesome. Like, Sage Talk.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you guys for joining us as well. You know, I'm really happy to be here. You know, very honored to have Mr. Elijah Moose on the show tonight. So,
a couple of the songs are going to be going next time. I promise you, I'm going to be keeping it real.
Awesome. All right. Well, have a great week. I'm sure some of you are off again tomorrow. Enjoy that day off. And we'll see you next Sunday.
Great. See you later.
As we knock everything down.
I watched it.
Happens.
Yeah, and you were just telling me about that too.
Booyah! The chair's big, that's all. Well, I was very happy with that. Look at that, 1 hour.